Hi, my name is Alan Michael. I'm a seminarian studying at Notre Dame Seminary in New Orleans.
Hi, my name is Nick Weiss, and I'm a seminarian for the Diocese of Dallas. I'm currently studying at Notre Dame Seminary in New Orleans.
Howdy, my name is Michael Ingram, and I am a second-year seminarian here at Holy Trinity Seminary in Irving, Texas. I am also a former St. Jude parishioner and staff member working in the youth ministry department.
Hello, my name is Kevin Polker, and I'm a seminarian in my third year of theology for Dallas, studying at Notre Dame Seminary in New Orleans.
This is my fifth year in seminary, and it has been so far the most blessed years of my life. The Lord has shown himself to me in so many ways and has helped me to grow into the man that I am today.
I'd like to share with you just a little bit about what it's like to be in seminary.
What strikes me is the importance of the work of priestly formation, that even a storm is not going to put it out of business. We do not stop priestly formation because of all these external circumstances.
The pandemic has taught me to be grateful for the people around me. It has helped me to cherish the opportunities that I have.
It has definitely been a challenging lifestyle, but I've grown a lot in just a greater understanding of God's love for me, but also in my own self-awareness as a person, recognizing that I have faults that I need to work on, but offering those up as a gift to the Lord.
That's one of the huge blessings, really, of seminary life is the community. I mean, being able to be with other men who are like-minded and desire to share their lives with others as priests has been such a blessing. And so I just want to say thank you so much for your support of seminarians and priests.
Whether priest, seminarian, or laity, may we all continue to be open to God's work within our hearts. Thank you and God bless.
Thank you so much for all of your support, and please know of the huge impact that St. Jude has had on me, both as a parishioner, as a staff member, but also now as a seminarian.
Just profoundly grateful for the people who support me in this journey of discernment, whether that be financially or through prayers. And so I want to express my heartfelt gratitude to all of you for your support, and know of my prayers for you.
I'd like to invite you to join us on Saturday, October 23rd, for the annual Clergy Appreciation Dinner. There will be great food and a silent auction.
If you are unable to attend, please visit us online to view the items to participate in the silent auction. Thank you and God bless.
Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to St. Jude. Today, our celebrant will be Father Simeon, and our deacon and homilist will be Deacon Ken. So please stand and join us in singing our opening song, Better Is One Day.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Good evening, my dear lovely people of God. We have once more gathered again to thank God for his blessings. We cannot recount all his blessings upon us this week. May all honor, adoration be his forever and ever. We are before our Father. Let us now present our individual petitions before him. We have all sinned against God and against our fellow human beings. Let us now ask God for pardon and mercy. Pause a while and tell God that you are sorry. I confess. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
We adore you, we glorify you, we give you.
Let us pray. Almighty ever living God, grant that we may always conform our will to yours and serve your majesty in sincerity of heart. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The Lord was pleased to crush him in infirmity. If he gives his life as an offering for sin, he shall see his descendants in a long life, and the will of the Lord shall be accomplished through him. Because of his affliction, he shall see the light in fullness of days. Through his suffering, my servant shall justify many, and their guilt he shall bear. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Lord, let your mercy be on us as we place our trust in you. Trust in you. Upright is the word of the Lord, and all his works are trustworthy. His love is justice and right, of the kindness of the Lord the earth is full.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, since we have a great priest who has passed through the heavens, Jesus, the Son of God, let us hold fast to our confession. For we do not have a high priest who is unable to sympathize with our weaknesses, but one who is similarly tested in every way, yet without sin. So let us confidently approach the throne of grace to receive mercy and find grace for timely help. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Again, Jesus left the district of Tyre and went by way of Sidon to the Sea of Galilee into the district of Decapolis. Try this again. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
According to Mark. Boy, I'm really doing it well. James and John, the sons of Zebedee, came to Jesus and said to him, "Teacher, we want you to do for us whatever we ask of you." He replied, "What do you wish me to do for you?" They answered him, "Grant that in your glory we may sit one at your right and the other at your left." Jesus said to them, "You do not know what you are asking. Can you drink the cup that I drink, or be baptized with the baptism which I am baptized?" They said to him, "We can." Jesus said to them, "The cup that I drink you will drink, and with the baptism with which I am baptized you will be baptized. But to sit at my right or at my left is not mine to give, but is for those for whom it has been prepared." When the 10 heard this, they became indignant at James and John. Jesus summoned them and said to them, "You know that those who are recognized as rulers over the Gentiles lord it over them, and their great ones make their authority over them felt. But it shall not be so among you. Rather, whoever wishes to be great among you will be your servant, and whoever wishes to be first among you will be the slave of all. For the Son of Man did not come to be served, but to serve and to give his life as a ransom for many." The Gospel of the Lord. Well, to be honest, these readings kind of make me uncomfortable. And I think the reason they do is because there's some truths in these readings, some truth that is not easy to take. For example, in our first reading from Isaiah, there's an excerpt from what is known as the Songs of the Suffering Servant. These excerpts are presumably, in retrospect, a description of Jesus from the Christian perspective. But how are we to understand the phrase, "The Lord was pleased to crush him in infirmity"? What does this even mean? Whoever this servant is willing to give his life as an offering for our sins. Whoever this is, God was willing to allow the suffering, allow the crushing to occur, because in the end, it was this innocent servant who was willing to give everything, including his or her own life, to show great love in this self-giving act. And so, from God's perspective, this guarantees a raising up in glory. So whether or not Isaiah is actually describing the Messiah to come, or whether or not Isaiah is talking about Jesus directly, Isaiah knew something of a truth about good and evil. The evil can only want to destroy outlandish good. So let's set that aside for a moment, and let's reflect on these readings with two fundamental realities, especially when it comes to God and humanity. First, it is in our nature to pursue perfect happiness and fulfillment. It's part of who we are. We pursue it all the time. God wants nothing more than for us to be happy and fulfilled for all of eternity. So this is good. We want to be happy. God wants to make us happy. Where things get disjointed, however, is when we think we know what it takes to be happy and fulfilled, and then trying to somehow get our lives to fit with that of what Jesus is asking us, particularly in these readings. Because let's face it, Jesus is asking us to do something that is not part of our human inclinations. In the gospel, Jesus told James and John, "The cup that I drink, that suffering that he suffered, you will drink, and with the baptism with which I am baptized," that is, what Jesus inherited, "you will be baptized. You also will inherit." What Jesus is referring to is that whenever someone does radical good, accompanying that radical good is a power of evil which is trying to stop that good. We may not suffer in the way Jesus did. We may not be condemned to death, mocked, spit upon, and scourged as Jesus was. But we are all being called to this radical goodness. And while this is not easy for us to come to grips with, Jesus is telling us that when we do the will of the Father guarantees us ultimate happiness and fulfillment. There was a word that I learned. It's called telos, T-E-L-O-S. In the Merriam-Webster dictionary, it's defined as an ultimate end. Through knowing our telos, our ultimate end, our life goal, as it were, we direct all that we do towards that end. For us humans, it is telos that drives us to pursue that which we were meant for, that which we were created for. The philosopher Aristotle saw telos as the purpose with which we were created. It is unchanging through the course of our lifetime. And when we pursue all the goods of our life, when we pursue our telos, then we have attained happiness. The Catholic Catechism talks about telos in paragraph 27. It says, "The desire for God is written on the human heart because we are created by God and for God, and God never ceases to draw us to himself. Only in God will we find the truth and happiness we never stop searching for." St. Augustine of Hippo, in his autobiography, The Confessions, states right at the beginning of the book, "You stir us so that praising you may bring us joy, because you have made us and drawn us to yourself, and our heart is unquiet it's restless until it rests in you. What St. Augustine is saying here is that we can never be fulfilled unless we realize that true fulfillment comes from God and God's will for our lives. In our gospel today, James and John are pursuing an ultimate end. They want to be fulfilled, and rightfully, they turn to Jesus and ask them to do something for them. They want to be seen as great leaders. They want to sit at the right and the left of Jesus, who they believe will establish a new kingdom after Jesus is raised from the dead on the third day. They misinterpret what Jesus told them. Not once, but three times in the Gospel of John, Gospel of Mark, Jesus tells them about his impending death and resurrection. In essence, they want to be part of this new order of Jesus' kingdom. And they want all the pomp and circumstances that goes along with being the right and left men of this earthly king, the king they thought Jesus would become. What James and John were asking for was something we might call positions of honor. They misunderstood their purpose. They misunderstood their telos. They were pursuing the wrong goal. And, frankly, they didn't understand Jesus' goal. Jesus' response was so interesting because he doesn't directly condemn James and John. He doesn't tell James and John something like, well, what makes you better than the rest? In fact, if you think about it, the other disciples were thinking the same way that James and John were thinking. They too felt they deserved a place of honor. Why should only James and John win that reward? In the gospel, it says they were indignant. Jesus was not singling out anyone in this situation. Jesus was trying to explain to all who heard him that while you are seeking to be fulfilled, and rightfully so, you do not know the source of fulfillment. You do not realize that to be fulfilled, you must give yourself entirely to others. You must be servants of all. If you truly want to be leaders among men, if you truly want to make a difference, don't do as the rulers of the world do. The rulers of the world lord it over them. They make their authority over them felt. Rulers of this world impose themselves on you. If you really want to be fulfilled, if you really want to be effective, here's how you do it. Be servants to all. If you want to be great, don't seek the things of this world. Rather, seek a relationship with God and let God direct you. Let God crush you to infirmity. Let God use you in a way that defeats evil. Let God determine your telos. What is so difficult in all this for me is why there has to be suffering in order for good to come about. Ronald Rollheiser, a Catholic priest, the missionary oblates of Mary Immaculate in San Antonio. He's a prolific writer, books and articles. One of the articles he wrote is called How Jesus Takes Away the Sins of the World. And he writes something that makes so much sense to me. He says, Jesus as the Lamb of God does not take away sin of the world by somehow carrying it off so that it is no longer present inside the community. He takes it away by transforming it, by changing it, by taking it inside of himself and transmuting it. We see examples of this throughout his entire life, although it is most manifest in the love and forgiveness he shows at the time of his death. In simple language, Jesus took away the sin of the community by taking in hatred and giving back love, by taking in anger and giving out graciousness, by taking in envy and giving back blessing, by taking in bitterness and giving out warmth, by taking in pettiness and giving back compassion, by taking in chaos and giving back peace, and by taking in sin and giving back forgiveness. I don't know about you, but I see these truths. I see how hatred and anger and envy and bitterness and all these other evils have to be thwarted by doing exactly the opposite.
But what does that mean for me and you in this day and age? What would it look like for us to live out our telos right here and right now? In a way, it's quite simple, but it's also very difficult. We all have to give of ourselves completely. And we all do from time to time. But let's start with this. Let's start by giving of ourselves more than we have ever given before. Kids, the things that you want the most, give it away to your friends. Maybe you have a favorite toy and your brother and sister want it, give it to them. Maybe that last scoop of ice cream was destined for you. Give up that ice cream to your brother or sister. Maybe clean up the house without being asked. Parents, the next time your child does something that makes you mad or upset, hug them first, then smack them. No, I'm just kidding, don't smack them. Hug them first, and then go about correcting them. When you are at work, do your work, then go about helping others do theirs. Be a servant to all, and amazing things can happen. Our telos on this earth is not only to become saints ourselves, but to make saints of everyone we encounter. We are most fulfilled, we are happiest when we become servants, especially to people who don't deserve our help. And that is the most difficult thing of all, to bring ourselves to help those we are angry with or dislike. It is when we do those things that are so contrary to our human inclinations that we are crushed to infirmity. In those times when we know what we should do but can't bring ourselves to do it, pray. Pray that God gives you the strength. And if you still can't do it, rest in God's forgiveness and then pray some more. When I receive communion, I pray a little prayer. I said it to my sons a few times. I pray this: Father, thank you for bringing your Son Jesus Christ to us and showing us the way. Help us to be more like him through your Holy Spirit. Amen.
Let us stand and profess our faith. I believe in one God, Christ is our suffering servant. taking on our faults and weaknesses. His forgiveness for our sins inspires us to pray with humble devotion.
For our bishops, that they will be guided by the same Holy Spirit that guided the apostles, let us pray to the Lord. For wisdom to understand God's living and active word as taught to us by the Catholic Church, let us pray to the Lord. For the sanctity of all life from conception to natural death, let us pray to the Lord. For prosperity to all those who work and help to all those who are seeking work, let us pray to the Lord. For an end to the COVID pandemic and healing for those who have it, let us pray to the Lord. For all those who are sick and who are dying, and for those names written in the St. Jude Book of Intentions, let us pray to the Lord. For all those who have died, especially Stephen Massey, Dr. Jesus Goh, Joan Jordan, Scott Bedell, Jane Lynch, William Bill Hartnell Blue, Jose Martinez Romero, Jose Mavelli, Robert Moore, James Lilly, Sister Celia Holloway, Michael Brett Hamilton, Stan Kavapil, John Nicholas Fajerin, Douglas Brewer, Sally Montemuro, Rosemary Wareb, Renee LeBeau, Maria Nye Nguyen, Sandra Argentioni, Hugh Mayer Sr., and Ted Valinokis. Let us pray to the Lord. And for the birthday of Catherine Bastian, whom this Mass is intended, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord God, let your mercy be on us as we place all our trust in you. We offer up our hopes and desires to you through your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit forever and ever.
Amen.
Your name is love.
also for the good things we have received when we offer you, for the divine woman and for all. Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be accepted to God the Father Almighty. Grant us, Lord, we pray, a sincere respect for your gifts, that through the purifying action of your grace, we may be cleansed by the very mysteries we serve, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with
your spirit. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Father, most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word, through whom you made all things, whom you sent as a Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin. Fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory as with one voice we acclaim. You are holy indeed, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dew fall, so that they become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." the mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Edward, our Bishop, Gregory, the Auxiliary Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Hear my son, our soul, we pray, that we, the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, we, the Blessed Joseph, our Holy Spouse, we, the Blessed Apostles, Saint Joseph, pure and all the saints, who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever."
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of all the world.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
The prayer of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire you with all my heart. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, I ask you to come spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already in my heart, and I unite myself to you completely. Please do not let me ever be separated from you.
Some announcements. Next weekend on Saturday, October 23rd, the Knights of Columbus are hosting their annual Clergy Appreciation Dinner. The funds raised will help support our clergy and seminarians. See a knight at the exit or go to our website under News and Events to sign up. The Knights of Columbus will be selling their barbecue to go after all the masses at the exits. Cost is $5 for a sandwich, chips, and sauce. Sounds pretty reasonable. On Saturday, October 30th, we will be having a trunk or treat event. We need donations of candy that can be dropped off in the reception area. In addition, there's a great need for groups to decorate cars and hand out candy. If you'd like to decorate your car and be part of the event, the deadline to register is this Monday, October 18th. Sign up under Parish News and Events on our website. The U.S. Conference of Catholic Bishops has designated October as Respect Life Month. Our parish will be helping 4 expectant moms living at the Missionaries of Charity maternity home by offering a baby shower. See the bulletin for items needed. Items are due next week, Sunday the 24th. Last week we shared the exciting information about our columbarium garden expansion project. As a reminder, you can purchase a niche at the current price before the prices increase in January. If you would like to know more about our upcoming expansion, we have a representative from, well, today we don't have the representatives from the business office, but if you go in the back, you can certainly write your name down and they will get a hold of you on Monday. Along with this, there's a beautiful brochure back there in the narthex, and you can find details on the columbarium page of our website. On November 2nd, we will be hosting a mass for remembrance of loved ones who have died. We ask that you register for this event and provide us with the names of any loved ones who have passed. You can find the registration information in our Hope page, on the website, or when you click Register Now on our homepage. As we prepare for our feast days of our patron, St. Jude, a novena to St. Jude will start October 20th. This involves 9 days of prayer asking for intercessions from our patron, St. Jude. St. Jude's feast day is October 28th. The novena can be found online and in the Sunday bulletins. Since we recently launched a new design for our website, we want to make everyone aware of the Registration Now button on our homepage. Whenever you need to register for a Hope event, religious education, or anything else, you can always find the Register Now icon on our homepage, which will take you to a general registration page. You can also find upcoming events on the News and Events page. Saturday night only, tonight, congratulations to the Scouts and American Heritage Girls on celebrating 10 years. I know there are some Scouts around here, right? If y'all could stand and let everybody see you. Thank you. So you are invited to join the Scouts and AHG in the Parish Hall tonight from 6 to 8 p.m. as they celebrate this great anniversary. All of these events and opportunities can be found on our bulletin and website. Also, collection boxes continue to be available. We thank you so much for your continued support.
Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, we pray, that benefiting from participation in heavenly things, we may be helped by what we give in this present age and prepared for the gifts that are eternal, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life. Thanks.
Keep us alive.